Archie's plans and the money from the dope, Dixie will be running this city by next year.
Huh?
Stay out
Found
of
it! Yeah.
Oh, ducking back! Yeah.
More's done.
Oh!
What's Four Finger got going on at the church?
There's all kinds of dope over at the church.
Get away!
If you destroy it, the boss is gonna lose a lot of money.
Here on out, I call the shots.
Oh.
Time's a wasting, bitch. I got brothers to bury.
Give me the doctor over here, fast!
About a hit and run in the hollow. If any of y'all got the patience for it, feel free to swing by. All units, search is called off. Repeat, abandoned search. Return to patrol.
I'm serious, man. You heard about the curse that witch put on Bobby.
That boy was weak-minded. And you are too, if you believe in that voodoo nonsense.
They say he couldn't get it up after that. Had that car accident. Couldn't sleep. The hair started falling out.
It was all in his head.
Oh, yeah? So why'd he shoot himself? What?
Light him up! show up sometime.
Pardon me.
He just crazy
out here. Run. He just shot him. I saw it. Watch yourself.
Oh, God. God, dear God, no. Get out of
You're so damn smart.
Well, looky here.
Beautiful day, huh?
Always good to see you, sir.
Y'all hear that? Get ready. He's feeling froggy.
Damn. Run.
Hey, safe here.
For the love of God, I'm being robbed.
Assault reported in the hollow. There's a unit in the area. You're welcome to check it out.
You're gonna tell me about the dope operation.
The boss has got enforcers dealing around the hall.
You run with me now.
All units in the...
time I'm doing this. Swear on my mother.
Police are gonna be everywhere.
That blood? Fuck it. 50,
one of those morons offered me a bracelet, said it was as good 100. As money. Told him to pawn it off and then bring me the money. Find out what the fuck that was!
We done lost one.
One of us. Move on.
Doing my job, which I fucking love.
Oh, shit! I'm hurt!
I've been listening in on old Charlie, and he isn't such a bad fellow. He's more of a kinder, gentler redneck, and as luck would have it, his wife is expecting.
Man in that situation usually doesn't care who he works for, long as he's still above ground.
poor sap starts blubbering when the two of them talk about names. Right now, it's between Bosefus and Thomas Lee. Anyway, his guys have the church locked down, and all of them are more of the shoot first, let God sort them out variety of redneck. You get your hands on Charlie, though. He'll do what he's told without putting up much of a fuss. All your intel's been updated.
You going back to the motel?
After I get something to eat. I'll see you when you're done dealing with these inbred assholes.
Told Richie not to put Charlie in charge of the heroin, but he insisted, said he owed Charlie's old man or some shit.
Charlie ain't half the man his pop was.
Ain't no time to lose. I found it.
Say goodbye. Cover my ass. Gotta reload.
Work for me, and you might live long enough to raise your family.
Okay, sure thing. Whatever you want.
That's good, Charlie. Real good. Send your men to the First Baptist Church. Those Dixie heathens have been handled.
I'll have some of my men come right over. And thanks.
State your name for the record.
Donovan. John.
Mr. Donovan, you understand that by appearing before this committee, you have explicitly waived your constitutional rights in regards to counsel and self-incrimination.
Sure.
And you further acknowledge that by appearing before this committee, you agree to disclose all information pertaining to the events that occurred in New Bordeaux during the summer and fall of 1968.
I wouldn't be sitting here if I didn't.
You were an operative in the Central Intelligence Agency from 1953 to 1969, is that correct?
That's right.
When did you arrive in Vietnam?
August of 1961.
Please describe for this committee the actions you took during your time in Vietnam.
I spent a couple months in Saigon. Then I was transferred to a base in Laos that was operated by the Special Activities Division. We trained and equipped the Hmong and then turned them loose on the NVA. We're running arms and supplies via the Ho Chi Minh Trail.
And you worked with Lincoln Clay in what eventually became the Phoenix Program.
Within a year or so, Lincoln was heading up his own PRU. We'd cross over into Vietnam and locate enemy targets and either kill them or bring them back for interrogation. Just thinking about it? Jesus Christ. You wouldn't believe the shit we did to those cocksuckers.
We're cleaning this place up right, thanks to you.
This man's name is Jesse. We were just having ourselves a little conversation about Richie Doucet.
Listen, I ain't done nothing, you hear? I don't know anything. I was just taking a walk and walking down the street and she just grabbed me is all.
You a Dixie Mafia?
No. Yes. I mean, shit. I did it for the money, you hear? I ain't got nothing personal against y'all. I don't even carry a gun.
Where's Doucet?
He's out of the abandoned amusement park to the west of here.
Banned Saturdays? What the hell is he doing out there?
From what I heard, it's because you've been tearing things up. Georgie's on a goddamn warpath. He wants Richie dead. So Richie, he grabbed what was left of the heroin and took off. Said he was gonna lay low until he could settle things with Georgie.
How many men he got with him?
Hell, I don't know. All of them.
Hand me that knife.
No, no, please. No, I ain't done nothing to y'all. Please, I'm begging you. My mama, my papa, shit.
Go on, get.
He could warn Doucet.
He ain't no threat to nobody. Let him run back home to his mama.
If you wrong, there'll be hell to pay.
Got a bad sense about this man.
Richie needs to work his shit out with Georgie.
Well, he ain't got no fucking choice. Because if he don't, we are fucked like yo mama on prom night.
For sure, man, for sure. Well, better get back to it before Bobby starts hollering again.
All right, then. Watch your ass down there.
Piss off that many niggers and not expect some kind of response.
It's one cool. Fuck this.
After all the fucking up Richie done, could be George's boys.
Don't matter if it's one coon or 50 grease balls. Only thing you worry about is the one motherfucker in front of you. I'm going.
Holler if you see something.
Troubles aside and enjoy yourself.
fine. I want to skin his ass myself. That fucker's dead. That's a new one.
Shit, here we go.
Getting my ass out of this shit. Pussy took off.
Light him up. Yeah, burn. I'm empty.
Gonna find a hole.
He ain't gonna know.
Moving behind something.
Hey, motherfucker!
Shit!
Did he send you?
Ran behind from the world and hoped to call
run this through, boy. You think you can come in here and steal my heroin without nobody noticing?
I'm not here to steal your heroin, Richie. I'm here to make you pay for what you did to Sammy and Ellis Robinson.
I didn't have nothing to do with it!
I watched you stab Ellis in the gut. I couldn't do nothing about it then, but I sure as hell can now.
Oh, God damn it. None of that was my idea, you hear? It was all Georgie, him and his old man. They wanted y'all gone, not me. What was I supposed to do, say no?
Either that or make sure that I was dead.
Oh, no, no, no. No, please, please, listen, listen. Just decent thing would be to let a man get in a prayer before you kill him.
You can pray on the way up.
When I saw Richie Doucette hanging from that Ferris wheel, I felt a profound sense of disbelief. Nothing like this had ever happened before. You mobsters killed each other all the time, but it was generally a small, contained event. Some greaseball is eating spaghetti and meatballs at his favorite restaurant and gets popped in the head. But this was different. Even then, even before I knew who killed him, I knew that Richie had been put on display. Lincoln was trained in psychological warfare by the CIA. He wanted to terrify the mob, wanted them to know he was going to kill every last one of them, and that none of them would be able to stop him.
How you doing?
to see you again, sir. Stay up here.
Look where you belong.
Hey, watch it.
Think he gonna shoot someone?
How you doing?
Mm-hmm. Get down! Get down!
Seth's dead. The Hollow's yours.
They say you strung him up on the old Ferris wheel.
He killed Ellis. Shit all over the people in this neighborhood. Doucette got what he deserved.
The righteous will rejoice when he sees the vengeance. He will bathe his feet in the blood of the wicked. That goes both ways, you know.
You said all that was behind us.
My men are struggling with the notion that we now have to answer to the same men who killed Baca, who wiped out half our number.
If I was them, I'd get over it. We don't have time to go around coddling people.
Of course not. But gestures carry weight. And if you were to help my man Emmanuel, that's a gesture that would go a long way in calming nerves.
What's he need?
He oversees my reefer operation over at the boathouse. Help him, and I'll see to it you get a potion of the profits.
Just so we're clear, I'm expecting a cut of everything, not just what comes from selling weed. It's gonna cost a lot of money to take down Marcano.
Don't worry. I'll make sure you get your money.
Use some supplies. Heard you were the man to talk to.
Cassandra said you might be calling. I'm happy to help, but I ain't running no charity either.
Anything you wanted?
Let me see what you got.
Okay.
come on.
Problems?
This goddamn thing keeps jamming up. If you're ready to see the other briefings, we can get started.
Show me what else you managed to dig up.
You got it. Two of the city's finest scumbags. The man himself, Mr. Vito Scaletta.
You gotta be shitting me.
Last couple months have been pretty tough on old Vito. Sal's always hated him. Thought he was a mole for the commission, but he couldn't do anything about it because Vito's maid. After the heist, Sal refused to pay Vito his cut, and then he put the clamps on him. He's been trying to limit Vito's ability to pay what's owed.
And if Scaletta can't kick up, the commissioner will give Marcano permission to whack him.
The only reason that Vito is still above ground is because he has a couple off-the-record businesses. He's been using that money to pay Sal.
Gotta give Scaletta credit. Pretty goddamn tenacious.
He's lasted a lot longer than I thought he would, but the clock is ticking. A couple weeks ago, Sal sent in his nephew, a kid named Michael Greco, to help Vito run River Row. Greco's been using his guys to limit what Vito can do, where he can go. Once he has Vito completely boxed in, he'll make his move.
Scaletta has to know what Greco has planned. I'll pay him a visit. See if I can't leverage this thing with Greco to bring Scaletta around to my way of thinking.
I'm sure I'll appreciate your concern. Oh, yes. Point for Dunn's favorite son, Thomas Burke.
How's he doing since Danny?
9 weeks ago, Burke stumbles into Roman the Butcher Barbieri's deli, drunk off his ass, waving a gun around. He fires off 10 rounds, but the only thing he manages to hit is a fucking ham hock in the goddamn deli case. The butcher's boys slap the shit out of him and toss him in a dumpster.
Barbieri's the one who took over Point Verdun, right? Busted up Burke's leg with a tire iron.
That's why Burke was willing to go along with the robbery. He thought he'd make things square with Sal, and he'd be able to get Point Verdun back.
He always struck me as an asshole.
Yeah, just like every other Irishman. But he hates Marcano as much as you do.
Yeah, all right. Least I can do is give Danny's old man a chance for a little payback. Oh, fucking hell.
He's been spending his time in a dive bar up in Point Verdun. Duffy's, it's called. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
Yo, you better be worth all this trouble.